Alright, so now I have begun my drawing process. I have finished my drawing with pencil. And I chose to use geometric shapes. Using this Canson paper, I've trimmed it down so that it is smaller and can fit in the frame that I want. Okay. And with the ruler, I divided my paper into threes and then I subdivided it from there. Okay. The paint that I'm using is the gouache paint value pack. Okay, this can be found in Michaels. And I have already chosen the colors that I want. I'm using an old canvas as my palette. You can use a piece of wood. Okay. Now, again, I already subdivided my paper and I created my design using a pencil and a ruler. Okay. So, now I'm going to go ahead and get started. You need a brush and a cup of water. All right, I'm not using my easel right now because I like working on a flatter surface. I usually use the easel for a canvas painting. Okay, so again, I'm using this canvas paper by Canson. You can order it online. All right, it has a great texture to it. It's perfect for gouache and oil paint and acrylics and watercolors. Okay, something with a heavier body to it. All right, and we're gonna go ahead and get started. So again, I've already chosen my colors. This is what the gouache looks like. Alright. Already chosen my colors. I'm using an old canvas as a palette. Alright. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. Now, sometimes I like to do randomization and just put colors where I want them. Clean off my brush to get started with another color. Alright, the opposite of blue is orange, so I'm gonna try and pair those together. So when you're looking on the color wheel, these are the complementary colors. So I want you to go ahead and get started on yours. I will see you for the next video, and I want you to focus on your color theory, what you know of it. Think about the color wheel and what colors are going to pop out the most and create the most contrast. Again, I will see you after the painting is finished. Again, this is Miss K. And you are painting with the artist K. Brooks N. Art.org.